Hello everyone, welcome to session number 2 in designing a 4-bit CLA adder in custom compiler in Synopsys tool. So we have started with the modular design approach, and in the last session number 1, we have designed generate circuit, right? And you know, inside it we have divided into submodule, and we have first generated an AND circuit, AND symbol, and then we combined the AND circuits together to make a generate circuit. So let's have a look at it in the custom compiler. So let me start with the library manager. So we have created a library, a 4-bit CLA adder test. In that we have created an AND block. Let us revise what we have done so far. In that we have created a schematic of AND gate. Here is a schematic of AND gate, followed by creating a symbol of a two input AND gate. Here is the symbol of a two input AND gate. And then we tested the AND gate using the test bench, which we have already seen last time. And then we followed up and carried on building a generate block. So in generate block, let me open it one by one. We have made the schematic of generate block. So let me show over here, where is the generate block? So first we implemented the AND gate in the, in the custom compiler in Synopsys. And then we worked on the generate circuit block. So this is implemented using static CMOS logic. So GI is AI into BI, where G0 to G3 terms are implemented by 4 AND gate blocks, right? So that's how the generate circuit block looks like. It will have 4 AND gates with inputs A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3, okay? So A0 to A3 is a 1 4-bit binary number. B0 to B3 is another 4-bit binary number. So this generate block will generate G0, G1, G2, G3, right? And that is what we have done over here. Let me open the schematic of generate block. Yeah. So if I just go to full screen so that you can able to view that. Yeah, so this is the generate block which I'm talking about. This is my 4 blocks with inputs from A0, B0, output is G0, A1, B1, output is G1, A2, B2, output is G2, A3, B3, output is G3. So this is how the generate blocks look like. And we have also created the symbol. Let me again go back to normal screen. And let me open the symbol which we created last session. So yeah, we created this symbol and we ended the session number 1 for 4-bit CLA adder design in Synopsys custom compiler tool. So here is my symbol which we have created of generate block having inputs, 8 inputs, A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3. Suffix we have given generate, indicating it's a generate input. Okay, we have also given a supply VDD and VSS. VSS acts as a ground. And this block has 4 outputs, G0, G1, G2, G3. So G0 will produce the product of A0, B0. G1 will produce the product of A1, B1. G2 will produce the product of A2, B2. And G3 will produce the product of A3, B3. Right? So to test this, we can create a test bench. In order to save time, I have already created a test bench. Last session, we have taught you all, you all have experienced how to create a test bench. So I'm not repeating that again, just to, just a quick revision on that. I will just explain the steps again. So let me open, you have to create a new cell and call it as a same cell block, but test bench, TB. And then you can go to view, create a schematic view of it. Then in the schematic view, let me start with the schematic view of this. Okay. And let me go to full screen mode. Yeah, so we are in the full screen mode. It's a little bit slow, but it's fine. Yeah, so let me show it to you what we have done. So this is the test bench. Test bench meaning we will actually test that symbol which we have created. So here we have using a generate block, right? Generate circuit block with all the 8 inputs. So all the 8 inputs, we have given the pulses. So those pulse definitions are over here. Let me show that also. So that's how we define the pulse definition. We have V voltage. Actually, DC voltage is also zero added over there. At the start, voltage one is zero, voltage two is 1.8. This is just a reference, but that is how we give it. Delay time, then we have a rise time, fall time. Rise time, fall time is generally same. Then pulse width followed by the period. So this is how the sequence structure is of the pulse. So that's what we have given over here. Here we have given 1.05 volt. It's a test bench, right? To test whether a generate block is working or no. And then we have labeled the wires as A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3, right? As you can see, it's a glowing symbol over here, G0, G1, G2, G3, because they are kept open, right? They should be centered via capacitive load, but they are kept open. It's just a warning it will give. I will show it to you. So if you open the console, if I save and compile the design, it will show warnings, four warnings, clearly stating that the output terminal, output nodes are open, right? Are floating actually. Okay, here it is. Okay, so that's absolutely fine. Normally it is, we don't keep the output like this. We have always sending it with capacitive load, but that's absolutely fine. Okay. So let me close this console. Yeah. And we have given a supply voltage also over here. So this is the test bench. And this is the schematic created for the test bench. Now we can test it. Test bench for the generate block. So I've already showed you the test bench, how to create that. I'll directly open it and revise the steps with you all. So this will open the test bench for the generate block. Yeah. So you remember when we create a test bench, we have to first give the model files. So you double click on the model files and then add the part over here, model file, TT, and then click on OK. Right. And then you define that analysis, that is will be a transient analysis. Start time zero, time step will be 1 nanosecond. Stop time is 20 nanoseconds. After defining that, we all go to the expressions part. So here we have A3, B3, G3, right? Then we can add A2, B2, G2, A1, B1, G1. And then we can add finally, A0, B0, G0. So we'll check that shortly. But before that, how to create this test bench? Okay, after you complete your schematic part, go to tools and click on prime wave. Okay, so in prime wave, you will get this block. Okay, get this options, right? Now let us add other signals also over here. Let me add A2. So it's very important to label it because we'll be selecting from the label. Then we'll add B2. It will automatically assign a different color for each variable of input and output. So now we are picking up another one from the schematic. That will be B2, followed by G2. Okay. So here is our block G2. Now we'll plot this, then we'll plot, A1, B1, G1, and A0, B0, G0. So first, let me simulate this, and let's test the generate block first. So I'll click on netlist and run. It will take 5 to 10 seconds for the output to arrive onto the screen. Okay, it's running. So very soon you will get the outputs. Yeah, it's there now. So let me maximize the screen. Yeah. So they are grouped together. Let me ungroup them. Right click. Click on ungroup. Yeah. So if I want to turn off the grid, I can do that. Yeah. Here it is. The red color is A3. This is B3. And this is G3. So G3 is A3 into B3. Right. So whenever A3 and B3 are high, the output is high. So here it is high, rest all the cases it is low. So G3 functionality is completed. Then we have B2, actually A2 is not plotted. Let me see that why it is not. So let me quickly check. Okay, yeah. This should be basically A. Yeah, A2 is there. Yeah, A2, B2, G2. Yeah, it's there. Let me check the results again. Okay. It's unmarked over there. That's why it was not plotting. Let me mark it over here. Okay, why it was not showing in the plot is that we have to select all the expressions which have to be plotted. So here we should have selected this. Tick mark this point over here. Okay. I think it's taking some time, more time. Yeah, it's been plotted now. And now if you view the simulation results, it will contain A2 also. So let me again quickly run the netlist and the schematic and the test bench. Now it will show the remaining plots also. So we have to ungroup them and view them individually. So let me ungroup them first. Then let me turn off the grid. Okay, fine. So your A3, B3 and G3 is completed. Now we'll come to A2. So A2 is this yellow color, B2 is blue and G2 is orange. So whenever A2 and B2 are, G2 is actually A2 into B2. So whenever A2 and B2 are high means logic 1. In this case, logic 1 is 1.05 volt. We have selected that value for the test bench. So here it is high, output is high over there. For all the remaining cases, for 00, 01 and 10, for between A2 and B2, G2 is basically high, right? So this functionality is complete. Let's now test G1 and G0. So let me double click over here. And instead of A3, we'll type over there A1. Okay. Instead of B3, we'll type over there B1. Instead of G3, we will type over there G1, then A0, B0. These are the labels which we have given to that wire name. And then finally G0. So in this way, we'll test the functionality of the entire generate circuit block. Okay. And now we'll go to simulation. Netlist and run. So again, it will take 5 to 10 seconds to view the plots. It depends upon your processor speed. So it's currently running and very soon we will view the output waveforms. Input-output waveforms perhaps. Yeah, here it is. So I'll maximize the screen. And let's ungroup them first. Yeah, let me turn off the grid also. Yeah, this is A1, B1, G1. So as you can clearly see, G1 is A1 into B1. Since whenever B1 and A1 are high, G1 is high, right? So G1 functionality is correct. Now let's check A0 and B0, G0. So whenever A0, B0 is 1, your G0 is 1, right? Rest for all cases, it is logic 0. So your G1 and G0 are also correct. So in this manner, we have tested the functionality of the generate circuit block. Okay, so generate circuit block, it's behaving absolutely perfectly, no problem at all. Now, let me close this down. Let me close this test bench and let me close this generate test bench block. Okay. So far we have worked upon the AND gate block. Then we created the test bench for AND gate, right? To view whether the AND gate functionality is correct or no. Then we worked out the generate block. We created the test bench today. Similarly, you can create a OR gate also. Now I'm not doing it from scratch. Let me go back to the PDF over here. So to create a OR gate, we have to first, we are building a transistor level implementation of OR gate using a custom compiler in Synopsys. So to design an OR gate using static CMOS logic, first we'll implement a NOR gate, right? So a NOR gate is created whenever we have a NMOS transistors in parallel in the pull-down network and PMOS transistors in series in a pull-up network. So the output will be a NOR gate. We pass, to the NOR gate, we pass the CMOS inverter and we get at the output a OR gate. So this circuit we have to implement in custom compiler. So we have already done that. I've already showed you the steps last time. So we are not repeating that again. Y'all can try it out on your own. So you have to create a cell over here. Then you have to click on the view and create a new schematic like this. So in order to save time, we have already done that. As you can clearly see over here we have two NMOS transistors in parallel in the pull-down network, two PMOS transistors in series in the pull-up network, followed by a CMOS inverter, right? And then we have done the interconnections with the wires, which are blue in color. And then we have defined the pins, input one, input two, red in color here, they are the pins. Supply pins, VDD and VSS, and the output pin out, right? And also remember that the body terminal of PMOS transistors are connected to VDD, and the body terminal of NMOS transistors are connected to the VSS, that is ground, right? And after creating the schematic, you have to also create a symbol. So we have already done that. So this is the symbol of a OR gate. So you can name it as OR gate. I have named over here as ISD underscore OR gate, right? So it will have two inputs and supply pins and output. So even if I double click, okay, fine, I've closed that. Again, I go to the symbol. If I close the schematic and if I just double click on the symbol, gate symbol, it should open up. Let me just, yeah. Okay, so this symbol is, the symbol for an OR gate. You have to save this symbol. And after creating the OR gate symbol and the schematic, you have to create a test bench. So I've already created a test bench over here. And that's how the schematic will look like of a test bench. If I let me just double click. Yeah, what I've done is I've double clicked on that test bench and this schematic has come, right? Correct. So yeah, let me open that schematic again. So if you double click on the symbol, your schematic will appear inside. I mean that, two input OR gate. So over here we have applied pulses, input one and input two. We have labeled the wire nodes. I mean the wire. We have applied VDD and VSS and output is, we have connected to the capacitive load of 1 picofarad. And now for creating a test bench, this is a schematic which we have created for the test bench. We have to go to tools and click on prime wave. Since we have already done it for AND gate, I'm not repeating that again. I've already created, saved a test bench for simulation. So let me show it to you. Let me close this first. So I've already saved it, the test bench. Directly we can view the output. Okay. So this is the test bench. You have to add the model files, the analysis type, and the input and output to view. So here, since I've already saved the test bench, I can directly view the output waveform. I can go to simulate, netlist, and run. Okay, it will take around 5 to 10 seconds for the output to appear. Yeah. So we are getting the output over here. Let me ungroup them. So I'll right click over here and click on ungroup. Yeah. So let me turn off the grid. Yeah. So here it is, input one, input two. And here we have the output. So it's a OR gate, right? So OR gate output will be zero, logic zero, whenever both the inputs are logic zero. So here in this case, both the inputs are logic zero. So in first case, we have one and zero, output is one. Inputs are one and one, logic one and one, output is one. Zero, one, output is one. Zero, zero, inputs are zero, zero, output is zero. So as you can clearly see, the functionality of the OR gate is verified over here, right? So that means we have verified the functionality of an OR gate. Now, next task is to build a propagate circuit block. So in a propagate circuit block, the PI equation is equal to AI plus BI. And this OR gate is implemented using static CMOS logic. So normally we have to generate the terms P0, P1, P2, P3, right? That is around A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, and A3, B3, right? All these are added. So that means A0, B0, A0 plus B0 will give you P0. That is the OR functionality. So we have already created an OR symbol and we have tested it. Now we'll be building up P0, P1, P2, P3, and we call it as a propagate circuit block. Okay, so here we are feeding in inputs A0 to A3 and B0 to B3, and this OR circuits will give us the output as P0, P1, P2, P3, and this block together we call it as a propagate circuit block. Okay, now since we have already created a generate block in the last session, what we will do is we'll directly, you know, check out the, you know, the simulation of another one, I mean the propagate block. So what I will do is I've already created this design in some other library. So I'll copy those cells from there. You have to create it from the scratch. Okay. So in just to save time, I will be doing it. So let me copy the propagate block from here. I'll copy to the target will be the library which we have created just now. And also the propagate block test bench. So again, I will be copying it to the library which we have created just now. Okay. Yeah. So let me go to the library of 4-bit CLA adder test. And here you see a newly created propagate block over here. Right. Let me see the schematic. So you also have to do it similarly. You have to create a new cell and then go to the view and create a schematic. Right. So when you go back to the schematic, here you have to create the propagate circuit block. We have 4 OR gates block over here. You can use the symbol of the OR gate, which we have created just now. Apply the inputs, 8 inputs, and observe P0, P1, P2, P3. So that is what we will be doing over here. So let me describe the circuit quickly by keeping it a full screen. Yeah. So as you can see clearly, I don't know how much it is visible, but let me just try it out to maximize a little more. Yeah, so this is my 4 OR gate blocks, which we have created. Okay, and we have applied the inputs A0, B0 will produce the output P0, A1, B1. Let me just maximize it a little more. Here it is. Okay. So we have created this blocks, OR gate blocks A0, B0, and OR gate will produce P0. Then A1, B1, PG stands for propagate signal. Okay. Just the naming pins we have given over there. Right. Then we have a OR gate again. A1, B1 will give P1. And then lower blocks will contain A2, B2 will give P2. P2 will be A2 plus B2. And P3 will be A3 plus B3. Right. As you can see, the VDDs are connected together and VSS are connected together. So we do the interconnections with the help of wire, which are blue, light blue in color. And this red color pins are my input pins. And P2 is my P1, P0 to P3 are my output pins, right? And now we have to test whether this circuit works or no. Before doing that, what we need to do is we need to create a symbol for such a schematic. Okay. So how to create a symbol? We'll go to design. We are not doing it because it's already ready with us. We'll go to new cell and you click on create cell view. So when you click on create cell view, you will get something like this. We'll got a symbolic representation of the schematic which you have created. That is a propagate block. Okay, so here it is. ISD underscore propagate block. I've given it a name like this. And it has all the 8 inputs, A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3, 4 outputs, P0, P1, P2, P3, VDD and VSS, right? So this becomes my propagate block. If I, let me just see, I have to now that I've created my propagate block, I have to create a test bench schematic, right? So let's just close it. Let me close it. So test bench is created to test whether that block works or no with the inputs, application of inputs. So you have to do it. You have to right click over here, create a new test bench for propagate block. Just name it and then go to view, right click, and then new, and then select the schematic. Let me show it to you. Click on new, and then you can select the schematic view like this, and then click on OK. Right, we have already done that, so I'm not repeating this step. So I'll go to the schematic part. So here is my schematic which I've created. Let me just maximize it if possible. Yeah, so this is my propagate block. If I, let's say, double click on it, I will get a four OR gates. And if I double click on the OR gate, I will get a OR gate schematic, right? So that's how the things are working over here. We are using a smaller modules to create a bigger modules, right? So let me again open the schematic. I hope it is clear, right? When we double click on it, we'll get the four OR gate blocks. And when we clicked on the OR gate, we got a schematic of the OR gate, right? So let me explain this to full screen, in full screen mode. So here, this is my propagate block. I have given 8 distinct signals as we have discussed while discussing generate blocks. Same signals, pulses are being given with rise time, fall time, similar to what we have given to the generate block. This is to test whether it works or no. And then we have labeled the wires as A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3, and output as P0 to P3 with the supply and ground, right? This over here, it's blinking because they are, floating, right? If you execute and check it, you'll get the same error. These outputs are floating. So that's fine. We are just testing it out. Or else, in order to avoid this warning, we can add it a capacitive load. But that is purely optional. And now you have created a test bench schematic. Now what you need to do is go to tools and click on prime way, right? That will create the test bench. Now we have already done that in the last session. So here I am just showing it to you. So let me open that schematic, the test bench which we have created. Yeah. So this is how the test bench will look like. When you create one, you have to add the model files, right? You have to set the transient analysis parameters over here. And then finally, you have to add the inputs. So here there are A3, B3, P3. Let me add A2 also. So I have to select A2 from here. And then I have to select B2 from the schematic. And then finally, P2. Okay. If you want to view all of them together, we can add A1 also. So here it is A1. Then we have A2. B1, sorry. Then we have P1 actually. We'll mark P1 from here. Then A0. This is to test the functionality of propagate block. Then A0 is selected. Next will be... Okay. Next will be B0. And finally, we will have output P0. Yeah, we are ready to simulate now. So after selecting of expressions, we'll click on simulate, netlist and run. It will take roughly around 5 to 10 seconds to simulate this. And so that we can view the timing waveforms, input and output versus time. Yeah, it's loading now. Yeah, it's loaded. So let me maximize the screen and ungroup the input outputs together. Ungroup them so that we can view them separately. Yeah, so this first one is A3, B3. So remember, what is P3? P3 is A3 plus B3, right? So that means it will be, zero when both A3 and B3 are zero. So here it is A3 and B3 are zero, output B3 is zero. Rest for all the cases, it will be one. So yeah, it's behaving properly. Then let's come back to P2. So P2 will be A2, B2, but B2 is not plotted, unfortunately. Let me go back over here and see why P2 was not plotted. Let me close the prime wave. Okay. In the expression, B2 was not there. Yeah, that was the problem. So here we have to select B2. Okay. And here it will be P2. Then we have A1. Then we have B1. We have missed out one term. A1. B1. Then we have over here, instead of A0, we should have P1. After that, A0, selected it properly. A0. Then we have to select B0. And finally P0. Now it will come properly. Okay, something else is getting plotted. Here it will be. Okay, A0 has been shifted up and down. That's fine. The functionality will be same only. So here it is A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2, B3. P0, P1, P2, P3. Yeah, that's fine. That's also fine. Absolutely fine. So let's plot it. I hope that all can be visible on the plot. Yeah. So let's simulate it and test it out. The propagate block. So it will take 5 to 10 seconds. Yeah, it has come now. Let me maximize the prime waveform view. I'll right click and I'll ungroup them. First, let's check whether all the inputs and outputs are present over here. Okay, we have A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2, B3, P0, P1, P2, P3. Yeah, correct. So first, let us check A0 and B0. So A0 and B0, and here we have P0. Can we just pull it up over here? Yeah, P0 can be shifted up and down. That's fine. Let's ungroup them. Group by name. Yeah. So now let us check it out. A0. This is B0 and we have P0. So it's an OR gate, right? A0, B0, A0 plus B0 will be P0, right? So we have to check blue. This is light pink and the output is also slightly on the. Yeah. So it's difficult to check one by one. So it should be in a sequence actually. So let me push this down. It should be, let me add P0 up. Yeah, now let us check it out. Okay, so yeah, here it is A0, A1, P0, right? So as you can see, whenever both A0 and not A1, actually here it should be, let me add it down. Let me add P0 a little down. Okay, here it is. A0, B0, P0. So whenever A0, P0 is 0, then the P0 will be 0, logic 0, right? And for all other cases, it is 1. It is behaving perfectly fine, right? And then we have A1. Where is A1 gone? So A1 and B1. Similarly, you can check remaining cases. I am sure that you will get proper. So let me test it out. A1 now, next. Okay, it's not viewing properly. Let me put it in a sequence manner. Then it will proper. Then it will be properly visible. Yeah. So here, what we will do is we'll check the sequence properly. So first I will have A3. Let me change the sequence. I'll correct the sequence and then we'll view the plot again. Okay, so the sequence is arranged in a proper manner. Now again, we'll go to simulation, netlist and run. Yeah, so now it will come in proper sequence so that we can check it sequentially. Yeah, we'll ungroup them. Yeah, now let us test it out one by one. So we have A3, B3, P3 will be A3 plus B3. So whenever A3 and B3 are logic 0, your P3 will be logic 0, else it is 1. So it is perfectly behaving, P3. Propagate term, then P2. P2 will be A2 plus B2. So whenever A2 and B2 is 0, output will be P2 will be 0. Rest all the cases, it is 1. Here it is. Yeah. P2 is also correct. Then we have A1 and B1. So whenever A1 and B1 are 0, P1 will be 0, else it is 1. Yeah. P1 also is correct. Then we have A0, B0. So P0 is A0 plus B0. So whenever A0, B0 is 0, P0 is logic 0. Yeah, it is also correct. So the functionality of the propagate circuit is verified right now. So that means we have built this propagate circuit successfully, right? So far in our model approach, let me go back to this. So we have successfully tested and built the propagate IP and the generate IP, right, along with the help of OR gates and AND gates, right? Now, I think that will be all for this session. Next time, what we will do is, let me just explain it to you. Let me close the test bench and the schematic. Okay, so next time we will start creating the cells for the sum and carry. So we'll work upon the sum circuit and all the carry circuits together, carry 1, carry 2, carry 3, carry 4, right? The procedure is very, very simple. First of all, you have to create a cell over here, then create the view for that cell, schematic view, then create the symbol, then create a test bench schematic, then create an actual test bench and simulate the waveform. So this is a simple 4-step process, right? So that is what we will going to see next, right? That's it for today. So far we have verified the generate block and the propagate block in the test bench and they are working absolutely fine. So next session number 3, we'll start by building a sum circuit and all the carry circuits together. So that's all for today. Thank you everyone.